only has one ally left. Let's see if you'll lead me to this person.
I'm so sorry, I got stuck in traffic.
Oh no, it's okay. I already ordered. Try the CC, it's delicious. There.
Wow, thank you.
Go ahead. There. Hey there. Why are you staring at me like that?
Nothing, I just...
What is it?
I just want to get to know you a lot better. Tell me... about your favorite hangouts, your hobbies, your family, your closest friends.
There's five of us. My other four siblings are all boys. I'm the eldest. They're a handful, but I love them more than anything in this world. And since I'm the eldest child, it's been my job to look out for them. Ever since I was a little girl, I've been helping my parents take care of them.
Sorry, I just want to ask, are your parents not earning enough to support all of you?
They earn enough. But the problem is my father has another family to feed.
Honestly, I really admire people like you who are dedicated to working hard for their families. I think your boyfriend's so lucky to have you.
I don't have a boyfriend.
Good to know. That means I have a shot.
What?
Here, try this. Do you really have to go right now?
Yes, I need to leave. I have to go to work.
Hello, sir. Terrorists are planning to blow up the park. The bomber's wearing denim shorts and a peach blouse. Please hurry.
Wait a minute. Who are you? Hello? Hello? You need to call the cops. We received a bomb threat. Go search the area.
What? Come on.
Let's go. You two, split up.
When is your next day off work? Thursday or Saturday?
I'll check my schedule.
What about Sunday? Let's spend the day together.
I'll probably be free on... maybe on Saturday, Sunday, and also... Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday... Thursday, Friday...
All right, then. Oh, no, I forgot my watch.
What?
I have to go back. If you need to leave, you can go ahead if you want.
No, I'll go with you.
It's all right. I don't want you to be late for work.
But, hey!
I'll text you later.
Okay.
Ma'am, can we take a look at your bag?
Huh? What? Why would you need to?
It's for security purposes.
Well, okay. Sir, what's going on?
What's this, ma'am?
That thing is not mine, sir. I have no idea how it got there.
Sir!
Wait!
We found a bomb in her bag!
Why do you have that?
That's not mine, sir. I already told him I don't know where that came from.
Call the bomb squad.
Evacuate the area! Leave!
But I just told you that thing in my bag is not mine, sir! Sir, you have to believe me. I don't know how that got there. That hurts, sir! Ouch!
Okay,
I swear that's not mine. I'm telling you the truth here. Please, sir!
Excellent work, kid.
I told you I could do it. You can always count on me.
Believe me, I'm innocent. I know nothing about that bomb.
If that's the case, how are you going to explain that to me?
But sir, those documents aren't mine.
Second Lieutenant Lilibeth Abarquez. There's no use denying it. Those papers show that house has been under your name for a long time. And upon further investigation, we were able to recover money, huge sums of it. A gun, and documents with subversive content. And how else are you going to explain the bomb that we found in your bag?
Sir, I don't know how it got there. I just saw it in my bag when the security guard said he wanted to check it.
You know, the guy I hired deserves an acting award.
sir? Okay. Hey, I need some room. Please stand back.
We recovered another cell phone in your bag. And one of the correspondents is addressed to you, Lieutenant. You were given orders to plant the bomb right inside the camp.
Hello, sir. Terrorists are planning to blow up the park. The bomber is wearing denim shorts and a peach blouse. Please hurry.
Why do you have that?
That's not mine, sir. I already told him I don't know where that came from.
So do you think that'll lure Ian out?
I'm sure it will, Ivan. The moment she finds out what happened to her best friend, she'll come out of hiding. And when that happens, I'm telling you, I'll get her myself.
Sir, please, you need to believe me. I really don't know anything about that bomb. I'm telling you the truth. You can run a background check on me. I will not oppose that.
We ran a background check on you, and we found out something. Lieutenant, we discovered
that one of your relatives is part of a rebel group.
Who are you talking about?
Wendell Valdivia. He's a known member of
a rebel group who's had clashes with the military. He is the son of
Rosalind Valdivia, your father's second wife. Based on his birth certificate, it is a fact
that you have the same biological father.
Sir, I and my family have never been in contact with my father's second family. This is the first time I'm hearing about this guy.
I think we're being played here. I want you to keep looking for Lieutenant Bonifacio.
Yes, sir.
Good work, Franco. Now Rian will be forced to come out in the open.
What did I tell you, Amelia? My son is smart, reliable, and cunning. You made me very proud today, son. Keep it up.
You can count on me to do a good job all the time.
Now all we have to do is wait. Rian is very sensitive. She'll always want to help her friends. Once she shows up, you'll know what to do.
Yes, I do know.
Good. We need to deliver weapons up north. Take care of it.
No problem. So, Amelia, what do you think?
He's doing good work. I knew it from the start. He has so much potential.
More than just potential. He has the drive. In time, he'll be able to manage the organization.
So what are you trying to say, Armando?
Franco is ready to be a leader.
Oh, sir.
Corporal, please leave us alone.
Yes, sir.
Sit down, Lieutenant.
Sir, I really need your help. Please have mercy on me. I swear I had nothing to do with that bomb, and I'm not a spy.
You're very good friends with Lieutenant Bonifacio, correct?
Correct, sir. In fact, our friendship started at Tasmok, when we were still trainees. That's where our friendship began.
That means you've been friends for quite a long time.
Yes, sir. It's like she and I are sisters. We treat each other like family. Since she doesn't have any relatives left, I became her family here at the camp.
You've been best friends with her for many years already. You even mentioned that you treat each other as sisters, like family.
Yes, sir.
Didn't you notice anything quite unusual or out of the ordinary about Lieutenant Bonifacio?
This is about the mission.
What mission, Rian?
How about the other houses? And are you really sure that no civilian is going to get hurt?
Rian, what are you doing here?
Quiet.
Shh. Rian, oh! Oh, I'm sorry. Well, wait, why do you have two cell phones?
Oh, yeah, you're right. Oh, no. I think I accidentally picked this up somewhere. I wonder who owns
this. Oh, my goodness. Are you a kleptomaniac?
Come on, I'm not.
Maybe that patient I assisted the other day knows her. Do you know him, Milet? No, I don't. She's actually never introduced me to any of her friends.
Lieutenant.
Sir? My friend is a good person, sir.
They even got Milet involved. She's innocent, yet they dragged her into this.
You should calm down, dear. And please don't do anything rash.
I really need to help her.
Rian, you have to listen to me. Do you know that many people are after you?
Of course I know that. But I can't just sit and do nothing while someone else is out there suffering all because of me. I have to do something to help her.
Rian, my dear, I know I can't stop you from doing what you want. But I'm going to ask you just this one thing. I want you to take care of yourself. Can you please do that? Be careful.
I've just reviewed your case, General. And I'm confident we can win because they've only got witnesses' testimonies as basis for their accusations against you. Just remember this. When they interrogate you, tell them everything we agreed on. We'll surely win this case, and then everything will go back to normal.
Attorney, can you please leave me and Armando alone?
Of course, General.
Armando, what did you say? Everything will be back to normal? Nothing will ever be back to normal. Because even if I manage to win this case I'm facing, Marshall already knows about my businesses. If we continue with the operations, Marshall will just keep on hunting us down and making us pay.
So what do you have in mind, General?
Copy.
General, everyone's in position.
All eyes on Chago Guerrero, sir.
Chago is not an ordinary terrorist. Is the area secured?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Men, get ready. Chago's arriving.
General Marshall de Leon, this is very kind of you. You went out of your way just to see me.
The day has come for justice to be served. You'll pay for everything that you've done.
What are you talking about, Marshall? I'm only a simple businessman who was falsely accused. Do you see those people outside? You can hear what they're chanting, right? All of them believe in me, and they're here to support me, because they all know that I am innocent.
You're really good at making up stories. You even fooled those innocent people. But that will end today at this court hearing. Take him away.
Court is now in session. The Honorable Judge Alfonso Villorante presiding.
The court hearing has started.
Justice!
I'm sure the general is inside.
Justice!
Please be seated. Today's case is that of Santiago Guerrero.
Prosecution calls Mr. Santiago Guerrero to the witness stand.
Hello, Franco. We're already here.
Mr. Santiago Guerrero.
You can call me General Chago.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
According to the testimonies of people who are your alleged allies, it's very clear to them exactly what your plan is. You plan to overthrow and replace the government.
Preposterous.
Is that true?
I'm so sorry, but I don't know anything about this alliance you're talking about. I'm just a simple businessman, and all my businesses are legal. You're free to investigate them. I'm not a part of any alliance against the government.
You faced a case before, which ended your military service. You once planned to overthrow the government by staging a coup. Is this correct?
Yes, that's true. But all of those things, I regret doing. I've paid for those, and I've already changed.
You've already changed? If that's true, Mr. Guerrero, then answer this question. Why are terrorists calling you their leader?
Attorney, I'll admit to this court that I'm indeed a leader, but I am a leader of people who are in need. Now, if it is against the law to help others who need assistance, well, you can throw me into jail right now.
What kind of help do you give, Mr. Guerrero? And please don't waste any more of the court's time by dilly-dallying. Just answer my question directly. Do you have any connections at all to terrorists or rebels?
All right. I'll admit to you this one truth. I'm going to tell you everything. Those people in uniform that you see inside this courtroom are the true rebels and criminals. What they attempted to do was to extort money, not just from me, but also from the people of Liwanag. I didn't give in to their demands, even if they said that resisting them would mean they'd cause havoc in our town. I stood my ground despite their threats, so that's why they're pressing false charges to ruin my reputation. They're suing me to intimidate me. That's the whole truth. Those people are the rebels.
Yes, that's true. The general's telling you the truth.
Yes, that's right.
That's right.
That's right.
Order! Order in the court!
We will have a recess. We will resume after 30 minutes. And when we get back to continue this hearing, I won't tolerate any further disturbance.
All rise.
Let's regroup after 30 minutes.
Okay, I'll go grab some help.
Secure the perimeter. Keep civilians out of the area.
Sir.
Any updates?
Most victims are in the ambulances. There are some missing, and that includes Chuck.
Clear the way! Do we have an update on what caused this?
A bomb has been found on the second floor of the building. We're still investigating who's behind this bombing.
How about Chago? Any leads?
We have none so far. But we've got men scouring the entire building. But I'm sure that he's the mastermind of the explosion.
Thank you.
I do not need to introduce myself. I'm gonna go straight to my questions. What is your involvement in the City Hall explosion?
I had nothing to do with it.
You were at the place where the explosion occurred.
But still, that doesn't mean I had any involvement in it.
Well, all right. Let's pretend that you're telling the truth for now. But tell me this, what about the encounter in the West Philippine Sea? The break-in that took place at General De Leon's office, and the smuggling case. Tell me now, were you involved?
It's true. I was involved in those.
But why? What was your motive for doing those things?
Ever since I was a child, they've been training me to carry out one mission.
Don't you ever forget this man's face. This is the man who killed your brother. He ruined our lives. He's the reason why we're suffering. His name is Marshal De Leon. That man is our mortal enemy.
They made me believe that the military and the government were the real enemies. Their principles became my principles. And I lived the life that they wanted for me.
So, you mean from the very beginning, you planned to do all of these things?
I entered the military to gather information. I manipulated some people in order to gain their trust.
Does that include Ethan? Did you deceive my family too? To fulfill your mission?
Absolutely everything on my own. By the way, the janitress, as well as Abarquez, I swear they're both innocent.
You may have worked alone, but every move was to follow someone else's orders. Who's that person? I need to know that person's name.
Santiago Guerrero.
And that's the reason you helped him escape.
I didn't.
Do you know where he is now? Tell me where he is!
I already told you everything that I know. And that's the truth.
All right. You have some time left before the court-martial proceedings. You will be appointed a military lawyer. And eventually a date will be set for a trial regarding this matter to take place. I hope you're ready to face everything.
Chago.
Hi there, Amelia. Did you miss me? I'm alive and kicking. Come on.
You're still able to crack jokes at this time?
Of course. Why not, coconut? Hi. How are you all? I'm good. Perfectly fine. Nothing to worry about. I'm great.
Are you sure you're great? How's your heart? Have you been having chest pains?
My heart is doing fine.
Because it only beats for you.
Why don't you stop? That's not funny.
Hi, General.
Hey.
Hi, General.
How are you? Good day to you. Great to see you. Hey, how are you? Don't worry. I'm doing fine.
Hi, General.
You actually thought that you were being funny? Everyone must be thinking that you're a terrorist in hiding. So I'm absolutely sure that they won't stop until they find and arrest you again.
Well, first of all, do you really believe that they'll be able to find me? Second, did you think I was gonna hide in a place where they can easily catch me? Do you actually think I'm that stupid? I've lived for many years evading the law. I am certainly as slippery as an eel. They won't find me. Hey! Amelia, we're not done talking. Don't leave! Hey!
Sir, I was just told by Lieutenant Colonel Dimagiba that you were planning to come with us to visit Rian.
Yes. I've been granted permission to do so. Surely there's nothing wrong with me talking to Rian.
Why do you even want to talk to her? Do you want to know every little detail of how she used and deceived you?
I'm just doing what my job requires me to.
You still love her despite everything that she did?
This has nothing to do with my relationship with Rian.
You're wrong, sir. Your relationship was a tool to spy on us. I hope you open your eyes, sir. I hope you never let her deceive you again.
That's enough talk. We should go. We're already running late.
Wait a minute, sir. That woman surely doesn't deserve your love. I know that it's hard to accept the truth, but I hope you remember that I'm always here for you.
See how nice this place is? It's very strategic. I have a 360-degree view of the whole place. As soon as enemies approach from any direction, I will be able to see them. It's brilliant. So how will they be able to catch me? Come on. I'm more clever than you know. No one in the world can outsmart Chago.
Hello? Yes, he's here. General, it's for you.
Is that our contact?
Yes.
Hello? Oh, by the way, you don't have to worry about anything. All our plans are still going to push through. And remember, this is not the end. This is only a new beginning. Okay, I'll see you soon. Thank you. Goodbye.
How are you doing?
I'm doing all right, Major Ethan Del Fierro.
Do you have an idea where Chago is?
I don't. You can keep asking the same question, but I'll give you the same answer.
You followed all of his orders. You infiltrated the military. and became his spy. Then I met you. Was I just part of this mission of yours? Rian.
It's true. I gained your trust to gather information.
Did you ever love me?
That has nothing to do with my case.
I need you to bring all of those inside. Then you call it a day. I just finished talking to Armando. Have you heard the news about Rian? She was at the city hall during the explosion.
What happened to her?
Unfortunately, that girl managed to survive. I'm starting to believe she's got 9 lives. But luckily for us, she's already used up 8. And now that she's on her last one, I'm going to make sure I finish her off this time.
So where is Rian?
Well, she got arrested, Chago. I'm telling you, we should get rid of her already. Because Rian is going to rat us out. Chago!
We're going to take her back from them.
Are you okay, Marshall? You seem to be deep in thought.
I'm okay.
I've been meaning to ask you this. Did Rian mention anything to you about Arabella?
Well, she's in our custody now. And she's going through a series of interrogations. So I'm sure that topic's gonna come up.
Is it possible for me to talk to her?
But dear,
I know that you're doing your very best. But even if I only spent a short time with Rian, I felt that, deep in my heart, I have this connection with her. Rian has a good heart, Marshall.
Rian was only using you.
That's just your head talking. But then, I always listen to my heart. I know that Rian was being genuine when we were together.
It's not that simple. Rian is deeply involved in Chago's organization.
I know that. But I believe that Rian is a good person, even if you and all the others think otherwise. Marshall, no one is absolutely evil. She had so many opportunities to hurt us, to use our family, to get revenge on us. If that really was her plan, then explain to me why she didn't do it.
Confirmed, sir. Chago managed to escape. We didn't find traces of him after the explosion. We have a CCTV footage of the man who got into the car with him. We're trying to find out, with the help of the National Police, to whom the Gateway car is registered.
The President has already declared that Chago Guerrero is a threat to national security, and the act he committed is an act of terrorism. Chago, and along with every person who's connected to him, is now our priority.
Lieutenant De Leon, has Bonifacio revealed any information about Chago?
Bonifacio still insists that she doesn't know anything. She also said she's ready to be court-martialed and be given a life sentence because she does not know Chago's whereabouts.
I'm going to talk to her.